To be or not to be in Smart Home Takeover.
Gordon removes the air freshener.
We find a new top tip for wood screws. I discard these instructions.
We find the secret compartment next to the S-Plan heating system.
And still manage to turn this dumb thermostat into a clever smart one.
We use the ferrule crimping tool.
Oh, and I love an app.
Good luck, Gordon.
Gary does a spot of plumbing. We change some lights.
We get an LED to come on and stay on.
And Gary's back with more plumbing top tips.
And that's why I love plumbing!
All this and more, and a special guest appearance from Gary on a smart camera.
So this is a house we've selected to take over in this series of videos. Built in 2015, it already has some incredible energy efficiency features, such as solar PV and a heat recovery system. But what's it lack, Gordon?
Well, it lacks any form of control, Gary. It's got some incredibly dumb features, and we're going to see, using smart technology, what we can do to improve the house from its energy efficiency, but also offer great convenience for the owner. So, should we dive in and have a look at what we've got to deal with?
Shall we?
Like a couple of moths drawn to an incandescent lamp, me and Gordon have turned up here at the consumer unit end. And having the house built in 2015, I think that was around about Amendment 3 of the wiring regulations when these turned to metal, didn't they, Gordon?
Yeah, well, perhaps this one just sneaked through, Gary. Perhaps it was designed, I don't know, 10 years before. Perhaps they put a brick in the ground, you know, and then, yeah, they managed to sneak through this plastic consumer unit.
Yeah, we're going to have a little look at some of the interesting features that have been left behind in this consumer, not only that it's plastic. Maybe we'll add that footage at the end of the video.
Yeah, we know. The eFIXX viewers love to see inside a consumer unit. So yeah, well, there's a treat to stay on for.
We've got a burglar alarm here. It looks like Wonky Joe's installed it. Okay, how smart is that burglar alarm system?
Yeah, it's a big problem with burglar alarm systems, isn't it? They're not smart. Have you got one?
I have got one, yes. Yeah.
Do you use it all the time?
I used it for the first evening that it was installed, and unfortunately the panel that was given to me by a good friend of mine failed in the first evening. At 2:30 in the morning, I was up a triple extending ladder trying to disconnect my siren.
Did anyone call the police?
Nope, and nobody came out to help me either.
Right, well, that's probably a big problem with traditional burglar alarm system ones like this one here. Ooh, yeah, you can see the code for it written in there very handily, is they don't offer many convenience features. You don't know whether it's Gary outside your house on a ladder or actually somebody burgling your house when you're away. Absolutely. And that's one of the areas we can look at in this video, as we put a smart system in that allows you to see what's going on in your house when you're not here.
Okay, I also saw when I looked inside the consumer unit, footage at the end, we had a transformer there for the bell system here as well. Is that something else we can improve?
Yes, again, smart doorbells are one of the most popular smart home products out there, so we're not just thinking about security, we're thinking about all those deliveries from an online retailer that we all get these days, Gary.
Do they come with next day delivery though, Gordon?
Yeah, they usually do, but obviously, yeah, you can have a conversation with the delivery driver using your smart doorbell, and yeah, tell them where to leave the parcel instead of just abandoning it in the wheelie bin as they normally do.
Shall we have a look at the heating system next, Gordon?
Let's have a look.
So why you brought me to this location then?
Okay, so this is the nerve center of the plumbing system, where all the pipe work for the hot water and the heating system comes together. And yeah, we're not normally a plumbing channel on eFIXX, but it's also where most of the wiring comes together for the controls for the heating and hot water system. So what have we got here? We've got two zone valves for the heating. So we've got an upstairs and a downstairs zone valve there. And we've also got another zone valve for the hot water system. So obviously they switch in and out to, obviously, you know, what's going to take priority, hot water or heating. But if you've somehow wandered in here because you're thinking I'm a DIY and I'm going to fit a smart thermostat, there's a very good reason hiding in this cupboard why you probably will want to call an electrician. You may already be there now, but it's hiding in this cover. In the cupboard, we're going to take a look at that now.
So you're going to reveal what's under that cover. It looks like somebody's already got half of it off already for you, Gordon.
Well, saving us a job, Gary. But yeah, so what we're expecting behind here is the S-Plan Plus wiring system layout. We're expecting it to be immaculately labelled and careful attention to plenty of wiring room, so it's going to be easy to work on to retrofit the relay for a smart thermostat.
Good.
And yeah, so interesting. There's another fuse spur around the corner. That's good. Congratulations to whoever got that on there, if this tank was actually in before they fitted it. So.
Okay, never getting back to that, are you?
No.
Good. Okay, so this is this fully labelled, neatly connected S-Plan Plus wiring system coming up.
Yeah, this is...
There we go. Yeah. You got it there, Gordon?
The screw out there. Nothing like burning your arm on a hot pot. Ooh.
Oh, hang on. Oh, let's have it. Let's...
methinks we've not...
Yeah.
A little explanation what's there, please.
Okay, so here's the wires from our zone valves. Here's the probably the cylinder stat for the hot water. We've probably got the some input from the thermostats on the walls downstairs, from the timer upstairs. Oh, someone, I think they've only even put one screw in there to do it. So we've got a collection of flexible and solid core neutrals in a block there that we're going to have to somehow tap into. So this is, yeah, when you buy your smart thermostat online, or perhaps you see it on the shelf all shiny in John Lewis, that, yeah, it looks so easy until you find this is probably not like those diagrams you find on the internet. Also interesting to note in here, Gary, here's our supply for the immersion heater in this tank as well. Now let's remember, this property's got solar PV panels on the roof, and as we've seen in a previous video, it's possible to fit a solar energy diverter. So instead of exporting the electricity from the solar panels, we can divert that, convert it into heat, and store that as in the hot water cylinder. So that's might something we might want to look at. So Gary, what are you doing here? I normally look at the controls and you get the wiring.
Absolutely, but I've looked at that S-Plan wiring system, Gordon. I think it's all yours. I'm in here, got the boiler behind me where the cash gets burnt. The only control system we've got here is the standard time clock telling me whether the heating is on or off, or whether the hot water is on or off. And then we've got a room thermostat with a rotary mechanism in order to generate the control for the actual heating system itself.
So you said that's simple, Gary, but looking at that artwork the previous owner's left on the wall, that doesn't look easy to set up.
No, it looks like there's been an LS Lousy been left behind here with actually how to program this little controller here. It's simply on or off, isn't it, Gordon?
It is. Well, you might set the time of day. But we'll look, if we're going to add a smart system to this, Gary, what are the advantages to the homeowner?
Well, the advantage is it becomes intelligent. It starts learning the patterns of when you're in and when you're out. It can also be activated remotely. So cold day, you're driving home from work, you fire up your central heating before you get home and return to a toasty warm house. Even left me a delicious pork pie. We like this, homeowner. I think it's time to look at lighting next. So we're straight into your world, Gordon. We're in the world of lighting, but how can we improve this lovely space with lights?
Yeah, well, Gary, yeah, back to my past world, Gary. We can do smart, but we can't do time travel. And we're in this home. Yeah, new homes, downlights, incredibly popular.
They are.
But if we go back to the rules our great friend Ray Maloney taught us, there's not much light on the walls, not much light on the ceiling, and that creates this kind of, yeah, it makes the space feel quite compact. So can we change that?
Well, hopefully we can by introducing maybe a smart light fitting or a smart lamp in order to change the atmosphere that can be created within this space.
Yeah, so we're going to see how we can quickly do an intervention just by changing a few lamps, possibly adding a bit of LED tape, and then also link that to some of the other smart devices in the house to have some fun and perhaps also improve security.
We promised you at the start of the video we'd go back to the consumer unit. We're going to open it up and have a look at it, and we'd like your feedback on some of the features in there. Okay, let's have a brief look at this consumer unit then, Gordon. Before we do, what's missing off the front?
Well, you don't necessarily need them on the front, Gary, okay. But there seems to be no labels, does it? So we don't know when it was installed, apart from the clue on the smoke alarm. We don't know when it's due for the next test, and we don't know who installed it in the first place.
Okay, so lacking stickers, but didn't we talk about solar PV earlier on? Shouldn't there be a sticker there for dual sources of energy?
Yeah, you're right there, Gary. That's interesting. I don't know what the implications were back in the previous edition of the wiring regulations, but there's the breaker there.
Okay, let's have a little look there. And again, one for comments below. Should there be a local means of isolation here to turn off the supply to the top of that breaker? We know in the roof space, Gordon, that we've got our inverter, yes. Yeah?
And there's two isolators you'd expect there.
There is.
Yeah, but it's interesting, it's very difficult to find out the performance of that solar system. We did track down the inverter. It has got a display that tells us what it's generating in that, but that is tucked away in the roof space. Also interesting to know, Gary.
Let's have a look.
We've got...
I know what we're going to say.
Yeah. There's a look in the symbol there. Type AC, RCD, with obviously... solar PV on there, so let's think about that DC leakage current perhaps as a potential problem.
Okay, we saw earlier on the wood screws holding the front on, yeah, and everybody's probably now noting that everything is energized, so we're going to take utmost care now. We're just going to slide this plastic cover off.
We're just having a sneak peek.
Yes.
Top tip there, if you lose the cover screws from MK Sentry, that it looks like a number 8 wood screw.
Okay.
About an inch and a half seems to do the job, so I suspect someone's lost the screws.
Well, we know the IP rating in here will be IP2X, so you can't touch any live parts, and we're certainly going to start poking around.
Yeah.
So there we go, folks. So that's what we've got in there. Now, considering what we've seen as we've gone around the installation, Gordon, that ain't too bad, is it?
Yeah, and this is the, reasonably well laid out. It's tidy-ish. And there's the wire we're going to have to be looking at soon when we look at our smart doorbell.
Okay.
That's not bell wire. It seems to have borrowed a wire off the old alarm system to wire in this bell transformer.
And of course, we've got two different bands of voltages there present within the same enclosure. So we've got to make sure the insulation of the bell wire is up to the same rated value of the mains voltage.
Yeah, we should do.
Okay, so we did look at the bonding as well, didn't we? So there is bonding here. We are talking about 2015. Mm. What was the incoming source material for gas and water?
It appeared to be plastic, Gary.
Okay, yeah, so it shows how we've moved on slightly, haven't we, as we've gone through. So, as always, we're interested in your comments. Is there anything else that you've spotted? We're only showing you a quick flyby glance at the consumer unit itself. Is there anything else you want us to highlight? Please leave those comments below.
Well, Gary, we've seen what challenges we've got ahead of us to make this house smart, more intelligent, but most importantly, get a grip of the energy in the house and also add some great convenience features for the homeowner.
As always, we're interested in your comments. What smart features would you like to see installed within this house? Please leave those comments below and we'll try and get back to as many as we can. Reckon they could fit a camera there, Gordon.
Yeah, you're right.